And this is how it came out, little joke aside. Now let's see how I managed to build my custom front radiator grille for the Audi A6 project. I didn't put the video on fast forward this time, I've left it to run for the most part of it. Just adjusted some cuts throughout a few sequences. For this part of the job, I'm using a Hot Staples plastic repair gun. It's very practical for hot bonding the honeycomb pattern to the actual frame grille, and it's also easy to use. Sorry for the camera angle, as in a few moments I didn't pay attention to it. Right throughout the video, you will see how this grille takes its shape while I'm merging the two pieces together. Free time is priceless, so finding some of it is very hard lately. Working on this project is constructive and enjoyable, but I engage to it only sometimes in the evening or during weekend hours. I have bought this honeycomb pattern grille as a universal part from an online shop. I don't advertise or promote it, as I don't have any affiliation to it. If you want one, just comment down below, or just throw out a simple lookout on the web. With the help of a search engine, you will find it or something like it. The dimensions that I used are 120 cm in length and 40 cm in width. If you want it converted, it would be 47.2 inches, again for the length, and 15.7 inches in width approximately. I've used the actual frame of the grille and put it right over this honeycomb piece to draw a line of its pattern on it so I can cut out its shape. If you didn't see that happening in the previous video, you can check it out. That was in part 9.3 of this job, and you can find the link down in the description, as I've attached it there. Watching a job like this at normal speed takes some nerves. I know it's not for everyone. If you can't wait, or don't want to wait, or don't want to see it like that, just jump forward or put it in fast forward. I let it for some people to watch it if they want to. It's not easy, and it's not for everybody, like I just said. I've welded the honeycomb grill in place, and tomorrow I will continue to finish to fuse all the staples needed. A new day has arrived, so let's keep this work ongoing.
E nu mai prins cu șuruburi.
After I've attached all the staples to have a perfect merge between the grill and the frame, I'm into cutting the leftovers so I can have a nice finish right on the edge of it. The battery on this little portable hand grinder had enough of it and surrendered. I will just replace it with the other one that's fully charged. Every time when you handcraft something, it takes time. It needs to be well done, so you can use it as it's supposed to be. Well, little mistakes appear, but I turn them into learning classes. So next time, I'll do it just better.
Ma
My father wants to help me all the time, at any given moment, or in any particular circumstance. I'm very thankful for that, and I appreciate it very much. Sometimes there is the need for gaining that self-confidence while doing something just on my own. I have went outside to check how it appears on the bumper, and have to say that it's just perfect. So now, let me show you a few close-ups from what I've done with this grill. On the inside, the honeycomb integrated even and nearly perfect throughout the entire margin of this frame. While on the outside it looks like it came out from the factory. In every way, the two pieces merge all together. At this stage, the work is more than 60% done. I just need to figure out how to seal the edges that I just welded in a clean and more presentable straight finish. with a blacked out chrome trim also attached to the frame, let's go outside and see how it looks directly on the car. I just forgot to put the number plate and the holder. Finally, it's also bolted onto the bumper. I was in a hurry, as I was leaving the country in a few hours and I didn't record the install of the grille to the bumper and the bumper to the car. But next time, I'll do it, as there is some unfinished business to this front end. The last picture I have taken the next day in a parking lot in the suburbs of München, Germany. Follow up for the next video to reach you, and God bless you.